Welcome to the first part of my Canada Travel Diaries, where we travel to Vancouver and Whistler. Hours later, we had landed and did some shopping at the outlet mall nearby, and then headed straight for Granville Island, a peninsula known for its public market. We wandered around during golden hour before heading to our hotel in downtown Vancouver, where we ended the day early. We woke up early the next morning to drive to Whistler, a world-renowned ski resort only about an hour and a half from Vancouver itself. We stayed in the Pan Pacific Hotel, which was conveniently located right by the ski chairlift, so we could literally walk out of our room and start skiing immediately.
I want to explore the village. However, you guys along with me.
We're getting our ski stuff fitted for tomorrow, our boots and skis, so we don't have to fuss around with that tomorrow.
It is seriously like an actual winter wonderland here. It's actually insane, guys. And this is not even like the start of it.
We took a night walk around the village and even Olympic Village, and it all felt so Christmassy and cozy with all the Christmas lights everywhere.
We're going downstairs for dinner, and as I mentioned before, we all walked around the village area, which is super central, super close to our hotel, which is really convenient, skiing as well, which we're doing tomorrow. And I'm just gonna call it a day, gonna get some sleep early because of a big day of skiing ahead of us tomorrow.
We experienced the best skiing of our lives in Whistler. There were so many trails to take, and the scenery was absolutely spectacular everywhere we went.
Hey guys, first day of skiing here. Oh, we're on the green route to start off with. Feels a little warm up. So far, everything is so gorgeous. Looks like we're literally in a snow globe. Look at the heights. Snow-capped mountains and the trees. It's so picturesque, guys.
We took the peak-to-peak gondola to the other side, Gladcombe Mountain, which is a scenic 10-minute ride.
We made it to the Olympic.
No, that's no point. Bro, can you actually go?
That peak-to-peak gondola.
Can you actually go?
Check some photos. We're heading down for our last run of the day.
Unfortunately, I only managed to film one full day here, but the other days we spent in Whistler were equally as fun, and I really hope to be back someday soon because we really had the time of our lives here.
Morning, guys. Day 3 in Whistler.
That's messy.
Veggie poutine for breakfast, you guys.
That's so big. How the hell are you going to finish that?
I'm not going to finish it.
We made it back to Vancouver and spent our second full day here at Capilino Suspension Bridge Park, which is a treetops walk with elevated suspension bridges. Did you look up to the sky and see
beautiful colors? Hey guys, where are we? We are at the Capilino Suspension Bridge Park here. And then, as you can see, we're elevated in the trees. And look at all the Christmas lights here. It is very festive.
We were lucky to have been there in December to experience the canyon lights, which are hundreds and thousands of holiday lights strung throughout the pine trees, which was truly a magical and enchanting sight.
Now we're on to the second part. We're going to do the cliff walk now, which goes along the edge of this cliff. Whoa! This is high. This is really high, but look how beautiful. Going through some light tunnel kind of thing. It's very cool. And it's like music playing along the walk as well, like Christmas music.
That was all I managed to film for our time in Vancouver, but stay tuned for upcoming vlogs where we travel to the Rocky Mountains, the highlight of the trip. I hope you enjoyed my first Canada vlog, and thank you so much for watching.